option that has really economically been beneficial to our operation. We let, instead of having, here I showed the scenario where those grass-finished steers were grazing the cover crops, we also let our cow herd graze those cover crops during the winter. We used to feed, you know, in North Dakota, here a year ago, we had snow 9 months in a row. Started snowing in September, finished in May. You know, it's not uncommon for us to have snow on the ground 7+ months of the year, you know. Now, some of that may leave and come back, but that's pretty common. But we use our livestock then, rather than bale hay and bale it all up, because that's the first question I get asked when people see those type of cover crops. Man, could you bale them? And I go, why do you want to? You know, my cattle got legs, don't yours? Let them get out there and find it for themselves. So we will winter our cows and our cow-calf pairs on those cover crop mixes. Hence the reason for species in there like hairy vetch, the turnips. I mean, those cattle will go right down through the snow. This picture, we didn't have a lot of snow at that time. Those calves are eating hairy vetch. Hairy vetch in December could still easily be 20-25% through protein, easily underneath that snow. So works really well, and the cattle do just fine on it. Now, I showed you, I'm going to show you a series of photos coming up here of that residue we started with and what happens the next year. This is what I like, and one of the problems we have, for instance, on the buses out yesterday, out to the tours, I noticed so many acres that weren't fenced, and I'm thinking, what a shame. We need to get livestock on the land. Dr. Williams mentioned this morning on how these prairie soils were formed with all the bison moving across them. What a shame it is now that people exclude livestock from the land. And a lot of people say, oh, but I can't have livestock on my land because of compaction. Compaction is a function of time. You know, you can't turn them on here, there, and leave them there the whole winter. We rotate our cattle in the winter like we do in the summer. Not as intense. Instead of moving them every day, we'll only move them once a week. But it really isn't a problem. And our soils up there obviously are froze pretty, you know, we'll freeze 6 feet deep, so we don't have to worry too much about compaction up there. But my point being, down here, you'd want to move them a little more often, but if you're moving them every week, it'll be just fine. We want those livestock to only take, though, during the winter, 1/3 of the above-ground biomass. We want to leave 2/3 as residue on that soil surface to protect that soil and to feed the macroorganisms the next year. This is in the spring of the year. This is, there was a radish there last year. You talk about infiltration force. You know, and I know there's some gentlemen here from Nevada, you know, we're talking about 4 inches of precip they get. It's not how much precipitation you get, it's how much you can store and save in your soil. Is it infiltrating into the soil and being stored? You know, Dr. Williams talked about what's being done with the watersheds and how we need to protect these watersheds. The problem isn't that we're getting too much moisture and nutrients on the land. It's that we're not storing it on our land and it's getting into the waterways and downstream. That's the problem. We need to store it onto our own farms and ranches.